So a lot of it, you know, it's interesting. When we started, and again, we're still doing an analysis, we're looking at these scores. But what's interesting is, and I want to bring our attention to it, and yeah, they in some cases they've dropped, but we've also increased the number, the percentage of kids that are essentially getting, all of our students are passing eighth grade Algebra 1, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So what you begin to see at some school districts where you push them too fast is you'll see low proficiency levels in multiple grade levels because we've pushed those kids so quickly through. In some districts, you'll see proficiency levels of 18% in grade 8 because they've pushed nearly 50% of their students into Algebra 1. And so having conversations with, you know, Freeman Rabowski and those types of people, and this was years ago, he would always say to us, why are we pushing these kids so fast? Why? Because you're going to take his calculus when you get to UMBC. Oh. Mm-hmm. You're going to. You know, so there's a lot of things there that we need to take in consideration. We're doing pretty well at 25%, and nearly, I think one student didn't pass, I think it's nearly 100% of our students pass in eighth grade. We've had the conversation with Mary Swack to say, could more kids qualify and do just as well? Yeah, we're definitely open to that. But you start to see proficiency levels begin to drop when you push, when you start to remove those other students and push them forward, if that's making any sense right now.
No, it is, and I appreciate you saying that, because one of the things that I've noticed, and this is just anecdotal, this is one person's experience, yeah. But you know, my daughter is in the honors math track at her school, and when she took the seventh grade assessment this year, her coursework was eighth grade coursework, but they get the seventh grade assessments, and so we looked at, you know, all the topics that were supposed to be tested for the seventh grade assessment and said, wait a minute, she never got instruction on several of those.
Those are the types of conversations that are having.
There's disjoints.
Yes, these conversations are the ones that Dr. Hart's referring to that are now beginning to take place in our curriculum office. Another piece is, you know, we look at accelerating, and again, I just sat in front of you for an hour and a half talking about G&T. But with that said, you know, you have to look at what percentage of the SAT, you know, is Algebra 2. You know, it's a fraction of it, right? It's mostly before that. So again, it's the same thing that folks run into, is that they're actually trying to remember back of things, concepts they've already learned to be on that assessment, because they're so far past it in some cases, and that's the point you're bringing up right now.
And that's exactly where I was trying to get to from the high school perspective, is that, you know, everybody's being tested on the 10th grade standards, but are they at all
varying
levels?
It's an Algebra 1, yeah. It's an Algebra 1 assessment that you're looking at to make sure that we're trying to get these kids to pass it, you know? So we have 100% passing, nearly 100% passing rate in 8th grade right now, which is nearly a quarter of our kids. You know, but then we have 75% that are going to have to pass it. Mm-hmm. And when will they pass
eventually.
It?
Eventually.
Yeah.